Hello. Hello, folks. Once again, welcome. It is great to have you all here this evening for our fourth Live at Hale event. Just quickly, show of hands, how many people have been with us for some of the other events we've had? Oh, good. We got a lot of newer folks who haven't been with us for some of these before. That's great. This has really become something that we've been having a lot of fun with at Hale. And a few of us on the staff were actually joking a little earlier that in some ways these little events, these little music things have become really these like things we get all excited about and we're having a lot of fun with it and it doesn't feel at all like it's part of our jobs. And you love when that happens. And part of it is just the opportunity to be with some musicians and hear some really cool music and have a different type of an event at Hale, and that's what tonight is all about. So we welcome you to that. As I mentioned before, we welcome Westwood Media Center. We're thrilled they're here. They've been doing a great job putting these on local access cable and on the YouTube, so it's a great way to sort of relive these events and share with others some of the great music we're gonna hear. And you know, one of the things about it for us at Hale is that we feel, you know, music is a great language. It's a language that does not know the bounds of economic borders, racial borders. It doesn't know anything about languages. It really is just something that we get to feel. And it's a way we can communicate in a really unique and interesting way. And tonight we have two wonderful performers who are going to share a lot of their music with us. And they're going to share with us the things that matter to them and some great storytelling and just sort of hearing what music means to them. And we're glad you're here to have that opportunity to hear that music with us tonight. We're lucky. We have tonight is sort of a homecoming evening as well. We have two performers who have Westwood roots or ties to Westwood. Later this evening, you'll hear Chris Trapper. Chris is a Westwood resident and spends his life touring the country playing music, and so we're lucky to have him with us. But first, we're going to welcome up Sophia Jane. And Sophia is a freshman at Berklee School of Music and a recent Westwood High School graduate. So one of our own, all of us in town, can feel very proud to have Sophia here. Now, I want to tell you a little bit about Sophia while she gets herself ready to go here. She is a singer-songwriter, and Sophia,
yes.
your website says from Boston, Massachusetts. Tonight, we're not going to let you get away with that.
Oh,
you're
I'm
from
sorry,
Westwood
exactly.
Tonight. Yeah, it's okay. We get that in the music world, it might be important that you say, I'm a singer-songwriter from Boston. But you know what? Tonight, you're from Westwood.
Yeah,
so,
you're
right? We're
I'll
from.
Change it,
no, it's okay. It's okay. She's been writing music for about 5 years now and is currently in the studio with the producer, Brian Feenley, and they're working on her debut album, Living for Now, which I believe is going to be coming out late this spring, this summer. Okay, this summer is coming out. She writes songs to clear her head and to let everything sort of get at the end of the day. It's a great way to sort of escape. Her music has been described as vulnerability to the extent of soul connection. So will you please join me in welcoming Sophia Jane for some soul connection.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. Oh. Y'all are such good clappers, my God. Okay. Hi, I'm Sophia Jane from Westwood, Mass, back again. I just took the train in from the city like an hour ago, the MBTA, horrible commute. but yeah, so I'm just going to start opening up with a song. We're going to talk. We're going to hang out. Yeah. So this is actually a song that I wrote, like one of the first songs I ever wrote. In high school. So you're going to hear a lot of high school songs, you're going to see. So this is called Take What's Earned.
Twenty-nine days, getting closer, I'm ready for an adventure. Pushed far away, but close enough to pull my tears straight from my doubt. I've gone this far, I don't know if I'm cut out for this. We won't know till we dive in. It's alright now, don't be alarmed. Build yourself up and take a turn. The future's bright now, don't close your eyes. A million reasons to stop, but why try? 10 more days. I think that I'll be okay. But is okay strong enough to fly me through to the other end? Use my tools and I will try to mend every hole. I'm gonna take control. It's alright now, don't be alarmed. Build yourself up and take a turn. The future's bright now, don't close your eyes. A million reasons to stop, but why try? Hey, didn't I get here on my own? I know more than I've ever known. It's a new me, me that's been here all along. It's alright now, don't be alarmed. Build yourself up and take a turn. The future's bright now, don't close your eyes. A million reasons to trust. It's alright now, don't be alarmed. Build yourself up and take a turn. The future's bright now, don't close your eyes. A million reasons to stop, but why try?
Thank you. Awesome. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yeah, so as Eric said, I go to school in Boston at Berkeley, which has been a nice change from Westwood. I came in from the train and my ears were like ringing here. It's so quiet, so nice. I have constant like beeping at my window, and someone drops glass at like 4 a.m. every morning. So it's been a nice change. But Berkeley, so you're gonna hear a couple love songs from me tonight, which is unlike me. Normally I don't write like that. But Berkeley is 75% men, and what does that leave? 25% women. So I've had some situations in the past 2 semesters that I couldn't help but write about. So this is one of them. I know, don't read too much into it. yeah, so this is a new one, and it's crazy because you don't have time to like write things at Berkeley because you're like constantly like doing work and all this stuff. So like these were born at like 2 a.m. off of like no sleep. So if I like slur the words, it's probably purposeful. I don't. We'll see. Yeah.
Oh. Love, I ache for that night. Oh, love, I ache for that night. Feel it in my bones. With it, I want more. Drunk, but not alone. You held me tighter than it all.
That night, when you poured yourself a drink,
showed me everything that made you you were. So pack me a suitcase. I wanna drive with you until we run out of miles. 'Cause I am lost in my own mind. Don't know if it's you and I, or if I need a little.
Thank you. So I was gonna play all original songs today, but I couldn't help but playing a Lumineers song because I love them and I'm always sharing them. and this is not in tune. I've been like messing around with like drop detuning and things. And I often forget, and I'll be on a stage, and I'll make this really strange, like, out-of-tuned sound. So I have to remember to tune it up. Okay, cool. So this is a song called Flowers in Your Hair by the Lumineers. And I just remember playing it, like, ever since I, like, started gigging in, like, 8th grade, 7th grade. And now I can't stop playing it. So I'm just going to play it for you guys because I love it. It's just so happy. And I tend to play a lot of sad songs. They're coming. So I'm trying to like pep you up so then like you don't drop so hard. When You'll see.
When we were younger, we thought everyone was on our side. Then we grew a little and romanticize the time I saw flowers in your hair. It takes a boy to live, it takes a man to pretend he was there. So then we grew a little and knew a lot, and so we demonstrated it to the cops and all the things we said. We were self-assured. It's a wisdom. It's a short one for being ignored. Be in my eye. Be in my heart. Be in my eye. I. Be in my heart. So now I think that I could love you back. I hope it's not too late, 'cause you're so attractive. Woman to make them compromise. Be in my eye. Be in my heart. Be in my eye. I. Be in my heart. Be in
Thank you. Okay, so now I'm gonna bring you down. I'm sorry. I started on my songwriting journey talking or writing a lot, like how I felt. Because when you're in middle school, when you're in high school, like it's down in the dumps. So they're lying to you when they tell you it's good. And so I just like loved coming home and just like writing about all my emotions into like a songbook. And so I started writing a lot about like how I felt with like anxiety and things like that, which like a lot of people don't talk about. And I kind of found a voice through that, and then through that was able to connect with other people who were kind of struggling with the same thing. And so I started writing all these songs. And when I was a freshman in high school, I went to the Berkeley 5-week program, and I was like a little itty baby there. I don't know, how old are you in freshman year? Like 14? Yeah, I was like 14. Everyone was like 19, which is how old I am now. And I just felt really small. And I remember like being there, my dad like dropped me off in the city. And he was like, okay, bye. And I was like, oh my God. Like, I'm already like anxious enough. And I remember like I ran to a practice room and I like locked myself in there, and I was like heavy breathing, surrounded by like all these older people. Y'all are probably like, 19 is not old. Like, I know, I'm sorry. yeah, so I was there, and that was when I like wrote my first song kind of about how I was feeling. And later in the summer program, I auditioned for like this songwriter showcase, and I was just like this little like 14-year-old, and I was like, I'm gonna play my song about like me crying in like a practice room. And they were like, yeah, we want you to play in front of people. So they chose like 10 people out of all the people at the Berkeley Summer Program to like play these songs, and I was like that little cute, like I had like a little bowl, weird cut, like haircut. I actually just chopped off all my hair like 3 days ago, so it's very traumatic. but yeah, so that has how this song was born, and kind of a lot of songs about mental health and mental illness kind of stemmed from this. So yeah, this song is called Heaving.
Locked back in the box I came from, back where the white noise clouds my head, where people try to talk me out of my reality. I'm not dead yet, at least I'm trying. The days go by as slow as seasons. By the time winter comes, it's been years. I try to branch out like the trees when and spring arrives, but the rain washes me down the gutter. And I try to trust that it's an illusion before my soul is shattered. Painful collision of mind and matter, a wave of self-panic washing me up on the shore. I'm lying there heaving the lungs that can't breathe anymore. Heaving. Heaving. Darkness lies, but I feel safe. I'm done with trying, I'll just sit here and watch the hours go by. Put on my disguise and try to trust that it's an illusion before my soul is shattered. Painful collision of my and matter, a wave of self-panic washing me up on the shore. I'm lying there heaving the lungs that can't breathe anymore. Heaving. Heaving. You've won the game, you've taken over. In my brain with full closure. Don't take me away, leave me here to stay. Heaving, but believing that it's an illusion before my soul is shattered. Painful collision of mind and matter, a wave of self-panic washing me up on the shore. I'm lying there heaving through lungs that can't breathe anymore. Heaving. Heaving.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay. So let's see. So going off of that, that was kind of like when I first started writing anything that kind of like meant a lot to me and wasn't just like, I like this boy, he's in my class, like he gave me a pencil. It wasn't like, I used to like write about like world peace. I was like, I love the world, like peace out. But like, this was like more depthful things. And so just this, I don't know how long it was ago. I think I was a junior in high school. I don't know if you guys know the Medina family, but, we lost the lovely Isabel Medina. She took her own life when I was in junior year. So 3 years ago, 4 years ago. And I know that really impacted me, and she was in my brother's grade. So I didn't know her, but I was friends with her sister, who was in my grade. And during that time, I didn't know her directly, but I like didn't know how to feel. And whenever I don't know how to feel, I just kind of like take everything that's in my mind and like put it down in a book. And I just remember being like, the weird thing about it was that like nobody knew that anything was happening. And that like just touched me so hard, because like everybody, like you walk around this world and everybody has something going on. And like, you don't think about it, but like, I know that I'm always in my own head and I'm like, I feel anxious and like no one else feels the way I feel. Like everyone like loves themselves. And like, I'm always like telling my mom, I'm like, no one understands. Like, I just can't get out of bed sometimes. And she's like, you don't even know. So it's crazy that like when it just upset me to think that something like this had to happen for people to like realize it. Especially in a high school where it wasn't really talked about and things are often like kept on the down low. And so I wrote this song and it's called One Call. And it was kind of like a, hey, mental illness exists, like keep your eyes open. Because yeah, it can be kind of uncomfortable to talk about, but like everyone struggles with it. Like it's literally, yeah. So anyway, I opened for Kevin Breal, who is like this comedian who, he has depression and lots of things, and he kind of brings like a humorous twist to it to have like a conversation with people. And the I'm Strong Foundation kind of hosted this benefit around that. And I opened for that with One Call. I talk very fast up here. I'm out of breath. And I opened for that, and that was kind of the first time I shared this song. And ever since, it is kind of like, oh, that's Sophia's mental illness song. Here it comes. So I'm going to play it for you guys. It's kind of just, I was inspired by like how I felt and how I've like talked and heard things from other people and kind of created a little story around it. So, yeah. She walks with no intention, drags herself from here to there. She's under some misconception that her lies will keep her clear from fear. She keeps dodging bullets left and right. It's a miracle she survived. Hiding under reality, dying mind and clueless society. She keeps screaming in her head, 'cause she can't find the words to say that she can't go on this way. But all it takes is one step forward. All it takes is one call to save her. All it takes, it's one step forward. All it takes is one call to save her. One call to save her. She's never here, never around, always sitting there in panic. And up her arm are the memories. Step forward, all it takes is one call to save her. All it takes is one step forward, all it takes is one call to save her. One call to save her. The bell rings out the door, she goes on the bus going home. Bus stops down the stairs, she walks to the front door, no one to watch. To the back room, there she goes, crying out 'cause she can't control. Takes her last breath before she goes. But
But all it took was one step forward. All it took was one call to save her. All it took was one step forward. All it took was one call to save her. One call to save her. One call, one call, one call. You could have saved her.
Thank you. Okay. Let's see. I have two more songs for y'all, with a little break in between. So as Eric Arnold mentioned, it's weird to call him Eric because his daughter is my best friend, and it's like, this is Eric. Hey, Mr. Arnold. But it's okay, because I've been calling him Eric for like the past whatever years, so I don't know if he likes it. We've never discussed it. I like it. yeah, so as he was saying, I am just as just this past, let's see, what is the date? Time goes by so fast. Just this past May, maybe, I finished up an Indiegogo campaign, which I put on, to record my first album, and we raised like $8,000. Bless all you people who donated. I love you all. And recording an album takes so much longer than I thought it would. I was like ready to like turn it around and be like, here it is. But it's been, we are now in the midst of doing bass tracks, which is a lot of fun. I get to like sit there and be like, good job, bassist. That's what we're doing right now, and I'm super excited about it. And this is the song I'm about to play you, is the single that we kind of recorded and fully produced for the campaign to be like, this is what, this is kind of what you, what you're gonna hear from me. So this is a song I wrote called Living For Now. It's not to be confused with like, I'm living for now. Like it's like live for the moment. A lot of people are like, you're living for now. Where are you going to go? It's not what it is. yeah, but it's the only song I have. I think you can download it on my website. I created the website and I don't even know how to work it. So, but I think it's downloadable. But this summer expect, an album out of 6 songs. And they're kind of like a culmination. I go to music school, I don't know any words. It's a grouping of kind of like a lot of songs I wrote in high school in like those 4 years of my life. And when I'll play a song at the end that's kind of more what I've been writing lately. But this is the headliner to that. Thank you.
drop you and move on my way. You don't want no tie down, you don't need no sad sound. When 6 months is mine, just hand me your heart now. I promise we won't fall down. Just trust us.
Hi, Sophia.
Should I stand here?
Yeah. Okay.
I'm Eric.
Hi, Eric.
Nice to meet you.
Do you have a middle name?
Yeah, right. You're Sophia Jane. Should I use my middle name while I'm standing with you?
Yes.
It's Paul. So you can call me Paul if you'd like.
Okay. So
so while Sophia is playing, I'm sitting here thinking to myself, I get a chance to sort of ask her a few questions while we're up here, and I've got like 100 questions running through my head that I want to ask her. And the first one is, how's Nigel?
Oh, my God. Nigel's so good. I just drove him. For all
Nigel's
of you who don't
her car.
Nigel's my car. I drive a Volvo Cross Country 2001. It's silver. It breaks, like, every day. And Kylie, your daughter, she drives a car named Marshall. A Subaru Outback.
Yeah, and Nigel lived in our driveway most of their senior year. So I just had to check that Nigel was still okay.
Great.
We can move on now to things about music.
Yeah,
so
okay.
So the recording process, I just had to check on Nigel before
fine,
we got going.
Fine.
The recording process, it's a big deal, huh?
Is
it scary in the studio? That's the type of thing that I think anyone who plays music thinks they want to someday record this big thing. And then when you're doing it, it must be quite something.
Yeah. Well, it's okay. I will say it's chiller than I thought it would be, which is good.
That's good.
No, it's fun. I'm recording at Plaid Dog Recording, which is in Alston. And I'm working with Brian, who's like the super chill guy. And it's fun because he is my producer and he is my engineer. So basically, like, I brought the songs to him and I was like, this is how I want them to sound. And he's a drummer, so that's super helpful. And he will, like, we'll just go to the live room and just play them out and he'll play something along with them. And it, we just kind of like create the songs and we're like, okay, this is what I'm going to do. And then
that's
we make
great.
Them. Yeah.
Has anybody listened to any of Sophia's music online?
Don't lie, just
have.
Say, yeah.
No, it's okay if that, actually the good news is that people haven't. Go to, what's the website?
www.sophiajanemusic.com.
Sophiajanemusic.com, and that song you just heard with a full band is quite something.
Oh,
I really
have
to
cool.
say, it is really, it's a fantastic song. It's great here too, don't get me wrong, keep playing like that, but the whole thing produced,
it's, cool.
it's really, it really came out nice.
It was fun to do.
It really came out nice, so
thank
you should be really happy about
thank
that.
You.
So what do you want to do with this music thing?
I thought you were going to say, what do you want to do with your life? And I was like, everyone is asking me
no,
that.
No, not
I don't
your life,
know.
But what about the music thing? So what's, is this like, after you produce this, and put this CD together, then what?
That's a really good, I don't even know what I'm going to eat for breakfast tomorrow.
Okay, that's fair
I
enough.
I mean, it's going to be out. Answer. I'm going to share it with the world. It's good because a lot of the time I will gig around and I'll be like at a bar or something. They'll be like, do you have your music? And I'm like, I have nothing to give you. Like, go to my Facebook page.
Right.
So it'll be good to have something to give to people. And
right. Well, I mean, like, Chris is going to, I'm sure he'll mention he's got his CDs outside.
Yeah, Chris
and
has a whole shebang.
And you, next time you play with us, you'll have your whole
maybe
CDs
I'll have
out
a
there.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
And we'll have a little table for you and do all that.
Thanks.
That's excellent. Right. So tell us a little bit, who are your influences? Who are the people who, like, have really shaped your music? Who do you listen to?
Who do I listen to?
Yeah, who do you listen to? I like one of the things I like to hear is who musicians listen to is like how I learn new good music that I want to listen to. So what are you listening to?
Well, I hate this question because I always never mention the person I actually listen to. I just like I forget it. Let's see. I'm trying to think. The Lumineers, Brandi Carlile. I'm like a really cheesy Sarah Bareilles fan. I'm not. I'm just gonna say it.
Oh, we got a couple fans back there. Good.
Yeah.
There you go. All right. Excellent.
You should check out, do you guys know Passenger? Passenger has a BFF called Stu Larson. You should check him out. He's super cool. He's like chose to be homeless. He kind of just like wanders around the world. Get a lot of inspiration from him.
The homeless part? Yeah, you know. What's worse?
Sorry, I mean the music part. Not
are,
the
is your, are your parents well, here, by the way? Did they
no,
make
okay,
it to
I don't even know where my mom is. I don't even think she's
I
here.
I don't like, know if she made it or whatever. Not. But good. That's probably good because you just talked about inspiration from someone who's homeless. Oh, I'm sure yeah. that would not be, she wouldn't
she,
be
well,
thrilled.
Well, she hasn't
that.
Heard from me in like a while.
Okay, she hasn't heard from me for a little while. Okay, great.
Anyway. She doesn't know I cut my. She doesn't. Yeah.
She doesn't know. Okay.
I love you, Mom. If you, okay. I don't think you are.
She's kidding. Okay, great. Well, hey, how about we hear one more yeah. song from Sophia? What do you guys think? We'll hear one
Yay.
More. And if some of you in the hall want to come in, this is a great time to come in. Unless you're happy out in the hall, but you can come on in if you'd like
you
to have a seat.
View.
You get a full view. Okay. Yeah. There's a little group out there. I don't know what happened to them. Sophia Jane for one more.
Thank you. Okay, this is my last song, so sad. I've been writing a lot more lately, and it's so cool at school because everybody is from, like, all over. At least 50% of my class is not from the United States, so that's so cool to be in ensembles with them and things like that. So you meet a lot of people from different places that obviously have lived different lives from you, so it's very inspiring. So I've had a lot of time to write and kind of reflect on that. And so this is a song very dear to my heart. This is called Seattle. And yeah, which I got to go to. Wait, I have to tell this. I got to go to, my like dream has like been, I wanted to go to Seattle. And I went to Seattle this past winter break, and the hype is, there's no hype. It's as cool as you think it is. yeah, and it was even better because I got my plane delayed because of the snowstorm, so I was stuck there for a week. My mom was like, are you coming home? I was like, no. Yeah, so this is kind of about that. It's a little more lovey than that.
Sleepless nights, west and east, coast colliding. It's little cold outside. Golden red leaves to bed and bare backs. The breeze treads just hold me for a while. Press me close, I do. Your breath, slow your mind. Show me Seattle tonight. The trees up above lead us down city streets that we've never heard of. We get lost in this. Lust that is spinning and turning and becoming love. Just hold me for a while. Press me close, eye to eye. Slow your breath, slow your gone by since we packed all our things up and moved to the lights. Young wanderlust, letting fate take the wheel means to sit back and trust. Just hold me for a while. Press me close.
Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you, Sophia. That was fantastic.
Thank you.
We are so lucky to have you as a Westwood alum, and we look forward to someday when you're on some stage huge and you say, my favorite show ever was that night that I played in Westwood in that little Powisset Lodge. And these are really your peeps. These are really your peeps, okay, right here in this room. So, you know, we'll move on in just a second and welcome Chris up here. But first I want to briefly, again, thank you all for coming tonight and just mention that this is a great big year for us here at Hale. If you are not aware, this is the 100th year Hale has been around. We have been here for quite a long time. Yeah. And it's a time where we're doing all sorts of cool and exciting new things. Somebody asked me earlier today, what do you do in this building? And we got to say for the first, well, we've been saying it for now 9 days or so, we run a school in this building. And we actually do run a school with 51 Boston Public School students who are spending their entire semester with us every day as this is their classroom and using the outdoors as their school. But Hale is doing a whole slew of really exciting new things, whether it's the new and newly rebranded summer club or all of our summer camps that are going on or our year-round programs. We're really happy to be in this community and doing so many things. And this music stuff is sort of part of that. It's this opportunity to be doing other things in our community, and we're glad so many of you are here tonight. I want to, I like to do this because these events have become really fun, and the musicians who have played at these events are great people. And they show up again. And so I got to acknowledge Ken Carter. Ken, first person to play. Raise your hand there, Ken. First person to play at a Live at Hale event is here. His buddy Zach, who just walked. Where's Zach? Zach played at one of our Hale events. Right there, there's Zach. Colin O'Dwyer has played in one of our events. And Chris Axworthy has played at one of our events. So, we love that our musicians are both fans and are part of this community that comes to see live music and be a part of these great experiences, and tonight is just another one of those nights. I'm going to begin introducing Chris, and I said to Chris, you know, make sure you come up on stage, but then I realized I've got so many cool things to say about him that he can just hang around for like an hour and 10 minutes, and then I'll be done, and then he'll come up on stage. So that's the way we're going to have this. But those of you who have followed Chris at all know that this is a guy who's been playing music for a while. He had continues to play in the band The Push Stars, and we'll hear, I'm sure, a little bit more about that band and their sort of rejuvenation as of late. But this is a band that, you know, in the late 90s recorded 5 or 6 albums, had a great touring season and all over the country, and opened up, as he said, for many of his heroes over the years as he worked and played in that band. Today, for the last 10 years, he has been referred to as a modern-day acoustic troubadour, typically playing 150 dates per year. That's a lot of nights out on the road playing music and doing just this, and we're lucky he's right here in Westwood. Happens to live in Westwood, so this was one of his easier dates, which is why his family could come real easily. They didn't have to go to Florida or something like that, where he just was, I believe. I will tell you that the Huffington Post says he's a brilliantly gifted songwriter. The New York Times calls him classic pop perfection. The Buffalo News, it's an incredibly rare musician, particularly in the world of popular music, who is able to forge a career based on the quiet dignity and steadfast integrity. It's going to be a family show. Dignity and integrity tonight are part of the theme, I think. But his humble sense of humility is what makes Trapper's song so strong. He makes you feel like you are the person he's singing about. So let's hope that tonight all the songs are about fun, really good, happy things, because he's singing about each one of us as he sings these songs. Let me please introduce to you Mr. Chris Trapper.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Eric. Give it up one more time for Sophia Jane, ladies and gentlemen. all the way from Westwood, Massachusetts. You guys doing okay? All right. Grab a coffee with cream and jump on the train. I'm through for the week, working too late. Living downtown, living downtown. My place is too small, but I can walk to the store for something to eat at 4:15. Living downtown, living downtown. Hey, ma, look at me now, 'cause your poor boy is making the rounds around downtown. My beautiful views of a sprawling brick wall. To check on the weather, I walk down the hall, living downtown. Living downtown. And there is this girl who reminds me of home. Reading a book and laughing alone. Living downtown. Living downtown. Hey, ma, look at me now. Fly with my feet on the ground around downtown. Dreamers take to the stage, and writers take to the page, and nothing is impossible, nothing is impossible. I say, I say. The champagne bars and musty cafes and taxi stands with people blowing away around downtown. Around downtown. There's stars on the avenue and rats in the trash, and an innocent tourist is stopping to ask me now. He's asking me how. Hey, ma, look at me now, all grown up and showing the way around downtown. Dreamers take to the stage, and writers take to the page, and nothing is impossible, nothing is impossible. I say. Thank you. Well, thank you, everybody. I'm going to start the set with a song about one that got away. Everybody has one that got away. It could be from this week. It could be from 25 years ago. It could be from 35 years ago. But we all have it. So. We used to dance, but the best clubs all are closed down. Now all of the music sounds mean. And what does it mean when the one thing I can't put down is a letter that you wrote to me at 23? And dream, I'm on the outside of a dream, praying that you could salvage me. I will be done. And no second chance was the last thing that she told me, and I was the fool who agreed. So I'm driving past all the places that we went to, when the kisses flowed so easily from you to me. And dream, I'm on the outside of a dream, praying that you could salvage me. Thy will be done. On and on and on and on, the smallest hope is never gone. My optimism always is well fed. And if I die before I wake, I pray for all the goodness sake that you are happy where you make your bed. Your bed. So I went to search, come to find out that you're married, with a sweet little child on the way. So I can't let go of the tiny dream I carried with me all these years, through all my fights and all my tears. And dream, I'm on the outside of a dream, praying that you could salvage me. Thy will be done. See in the artificial lives something that you always denied. Now I'm the one. On and on and on and on, the smallest hope is never gone. My optimism always is well fed. And if I die before I wake, I pray for all the goodness sake that you are happy where you make your bed. Yeah! On and on and on and on, the smallest hope is never gone. My optimism always is well fed. And if I die before I wake, I pray for all the goodness sake that you are happy where you make your bed. Your bed.
Well, thank you very much. Good evening. Welcome. One more time for Sophia Jane. Yeah.
I have to say I'm very, very excited to be playing a gig that I am literally 2 miles from my house. I will be in bed by 10:45, which is very, very exciting. It's for me, it's a huge career achievement. To be in bed by 10:45, it never happens. It's very exciting. I can remember the first time I picked up a guitar as a little kid, and I was wearing my mom's spandex pants. She used to wear spandex pants, so I put them on and grab a guitar, pretend I was just She's the biggest rock star in the whole world. You'd be sitting there in the mirror. I'd picture a fog machine. I'd picture an electric light show. I'd picture a dancing girl. I'd picture the whole thing. And in my head, I was dreaming that someday I'd be headlining Westwood, Massachusetts. It's one of those things where I was like, someday, if all my dreams come true, I'll be playing at Hale Reservation. That's right. Very, very exciting to have. It's exciting to have your dreams come true. Actually, the cool thing is my wife used to lifeguard here. And she used to wear the red Baywatch style, tankini type of thing. And my kids have been here for years, about 7 years we were members here, and certain turtle that was evading us for many, many years. We saw it once and it never showed up again. It was like the Loch Ness Monster. It showed up and then disappeared, never to show up again. So I just got back from tour in Florida, which is very exciting. I was saying to a friend of mine who just got back from Germany, he said, Chris, I was driving on the Autobahn. It's so dangerous. They drive 120 miles an hour. It's unbelievable. It's so reckless. It's so scary. It's so dangerous. Then a different friend of mine got back from Southeast Asia. He said, Chris, you would not believe it. There are no rules there. People drive. There's no traffic lights. There's 10 people riding on one, truck, and they're falling off. There's no rules. It's so reckless. It's so scary. And I said to them, apparently you've never driven in Florida. It's way more dangerous. Because apparently when you're in Florida, you reach a certain age where you just don't have that much to live for. Where a Starbucks parking lot, I'm pulling into a parking space, and this old lady is pulling in. She doesn't seem to care that we're about to crash. Like, we're inches from... I'm already ready to call my insurance guy. I'm going to have to call him. So I'm like, you can have the space because you have less time to live. Hope, knock on wood. Even standing on a normal street there is just like standing in the middle of the Indy 500, like on the track, because cars roll by left and right. I was watching I have no segue for this next bit. I'm just going to go for it. I was watching a news program this afternoon. I won't say which news channel, because I don't want to polarize. In Massachusetts, 1% of my audience, I don't want to polarize it. But every other advertisement is for some kind of drug. And then Chantix, apparently an anti-cigarette smoking, drug. A lot of the side effects are kind of a little bit weirder than smoking itself. He's like, you may have suicidal thoughts. Maybe I'll smoke instead of having suicidal thoughts, just in case that thought becomes reality. This guy says, I was out having a cigarette when my son made his winning shot. I was thinking to myself that is such an exaggeration, because my dad chain-smoked my whole life, my whole childhood, and he never missed my winning shot. Because I never made a winning shot. Anyway, welcome to the show. It's great to be here at Hale Reservation. And I'm going to play a song. So when I play San Diego, I have a decent following there. I play a fairly decent show. And there's a fan of mine who's become a friend over the years, and he's also a singer, and he usually has a gig booked the same night as me in the same street down the block. And he says, Chris, why don't you come check out my gig, and you'll see what it's like. And so I go see his gig, and even if I have a bad night, his gig cheers me up, because it's usually not that glamorous. Go see him play, and it's kind of him standing in a corner have a bar where nobody's listening to him. I usually have a quiet crowd like this, like a library or a 12-step support group. It's like a very similar vibe, but and so I'm checking him out. He's standing in a corner. There's no lights. No one's listening to him. There's like sports on TV, as we were discussing earlier, and there's no glamour to it. Not only that, but he's doing songs like Who Let the Dogs Out and Macarena and whatever that Lou Bega shit song is from years ago, whatever that's called. So I decided I had to write a song for him. So this is a brand new song for me. For some odd reason, I only wrote this on two strings. I don't know why I am aware that the guitar has six strings, but for some reason I opted to only use two. I've been up, I've been down, I've been all over this town. Coke and champagne, pieces on the ground. I would pick myself up, dust myself off. You wouldn't believe the beautiful things that you could find when you were lost. But then I grew up into a suit and a job in a one-bedroom apartment. Felt like my soul was being robbed. Walked through the office like a zombie, all day staring at the screen. Wouldn't believe the minuscule things that would make me want to scream. But I don't care enough to be the one you love. And I don't care enough to be the one you love. Still I remember the day I realized I was smarter than my boss. I told him where to go after he told me to get lost. Then we walked into the daylight feeling like my life was done. Wouldn't believe the liberating feeling to be blinded by the sun. But summer turned to winter, my apartment turned cold. I was about to be evicted, or so the certified letter told. So I picked up my guitar and walked into the corner bar. They said, if you can fill 3 hours up on the stage, and there you are. But I don't care enough to be the one you love. You love. And I don't care enough to be the one you love. You love. I was a nightclub singer and things were going fine till the 999th time some drunk requested Sweet Caroline. I just stuck up my middle finger, then smashed my glass of wine. Then I stormed off of the stage and saved my soul in the nick of time. But I don't care enough to be the one you love. You love. And I don't care enough to be the one you love, you love. And I don't care enough to be the one you love. And I don't care enough to be the one you love. And I don't care enough to be the one you love. I'd say the acoustics from where I'm standing makes it feel like I'm playing a stadium because your applause is so loud and beautiful. So, thank you. It's very acoustically perfect.
I'm always fascinated by the fact that people have to stop and look at accidents. If for some reason we have to stop and look. And I try to romanticize what that reason is. Well, don't remind me where I should be. I am here and you're here too, it's just the two of us, and isn't that enough? Just stay beside me through the morning, as the sun streams through the dust that turns to glitter, sailing round the both of us. Drove slow past the accident, too many cars up in smoke. I thought as I was passing it that you're my only hope. You're my only hope. Don't receive me with a blessing. If you knew half of the sins I've done, you'd probably never talk to me again. Just walk beside me through the thunder, cause I fear what's coming around the corners more than one of us could take along. Drove slow past the accident, too many cars up in smoke. I thought as I was passing it that you're my only hope. You're my only. Thank you so much. I'm still getting sound, so I can just keep this ending going. Jennifer, is there a set list back there? Do I think I left my set list? What's in your pocket? I knew you stole my set list. How did that happen? I mean, I could do the show without a set list. Not that I'm bragging, but I could. I don't need this. Thank you. I'm going to do a song it's actually brand new. I've never played this live before, ever. So I figure Hale Reservation might be the best place I should try it out. Because you're a very loving, forgiving crowd. So, but this is a song that I wrote for my band. Because I'm just about to embark on some reunion stuff with my old band. And so I wanted to write the story of our band. So this is a song called So new that I don't have a title for it yet. That's how new it is. So I tried to disguise a bunch of music business things that happened to our band within this song.
So it sounds like I'm talking about a circus, but I'm talking about the music business. Just to give you a little behind the scenes information. I don't miss the arguments over what to feed the elephants or where to pitch our tent up in this town. Or juggling the acrobats who drank too much of this or that, or fighting off my fear of falling down. No, I don't miss the mornings and all the two-bit towns. I may not miss the circus, but I sure do miss the clowns. No, I don't miss the bickering, whether the fat lady was gonna sing. It always was an old familiar sound. We watched the human cannonball blow a hole straight through the wall. We picked him up in pieces on the ground. 'Cause yes, it got so lonesome when the moon went down. I may not miss the circus, but I sure do miss the clown. Dusting off the old trapeze, there's splints and cramps in both my knees. The mirror went and stole half of my hair, but I still have my calloused hands and a heart just sore before it lands, even if it's 3 feet in the air. 'Cause I still see sad kids smiling through the glow stick spinning round. I may not miss the circus, but I sure do miss the clowns. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
I appreciate it. Thank you. This is a song that I had in a film called There's Something About Mary, and this is a song called Everything Shines. It's not how it used to start out, but I added the cartoon, like the anvil's about to fall introduction. Well, hey, come this May, we'll be running in the sun again. Your time will come. You're just a young, broken heart, been out sleeping in the yard. How could you be so dumb? All we losers stand in line, just waiting for our time. Broken angel, take that plane and finger paint the sky till everything shines. Everything shines, yeah. Everything shines. Oh, broken clock. Haven't heard your old tick-tocking, man, for much too long. And lonely jukebox in the corner of a nightclub, man, I need your song. All we losers stand in line just waiting for our time. Broken angel, take that plane and finger paint the sky till everything shines. Everything shines, yeah, yeah. Everything shines. Everything shines, yeah, yeah. Everything shines. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Well, thank you so much. I'm just going to play this. I'm going to play a little tribute to Boston, because we're close enough to Boston. A song called Boston Girl. And I wrote this at the end of an 8-month-long tour that I talk about all the places that I'd just been to on tour, and I kind of trash them. At the end of the song, I just talk about how cool Boston is. So, Boston Girl. You know, I play this really fast. My kids are here, and they're just way past their bedtime, so I'm going to pick it up. I'm going to try and play this the fastest I've ever played this in my entire life tonight. Okay, here we go. But it has a lot of lyrics. So it's very, very hard to fit them all in. And I'm not going to stop interrupting the song to talk. I'm just going to play the song, and I'm not going to talk anymore at all. It's a little more of the guitar. From Nashville to Asheville, North Carolina, I searched far and wide to see if I could find a woman I could call my own, so I could buy her a ring and I could build her a home. But I always ended up by myself, with the blues in my heart and my love on the shelf. So I went from Chicago to Detroit, Michigan, but I left the singer's bar thinking I'd never have a wish again. Then off to Minneapolis and maybe St. Paul, but the girls that have an accent I don't understand at all. Telling you boys, they've been across the world. If you want to fall in love, go find a Boston girl. Well, when I got to L.A., things couldn't have been worse. I was kissing with the girl and her implant burst. I didn't want a porn star or an actress wannabe, so moved to San Francisco, but my she was a he. And oh, woe is me, off to Salt Lake City, Utah, where if you look at a girl, you're breaking the law. I even had a date with a psycho in Seattle. We're picking the restaurant and the movie was the battle. And in Phoenix, Arizona, had a candlelight dinner, but you ate with the hands and wiped your face with the fingers. Telling your boys I've been across the world. I want an elegant, intelligent Boston girl. Boston girl. Boston girl. Boston girl, Boston girl. Well, Albany's so fun, I spent a month there one day. But Westwood is cool, so I can't stay away. In Philly and Washington, Atlantic City, I was searching and sunk until it finally hit me that maybe I should end my year-long trip and forget about the dream of a relationship. Connect to the Mass Pike of I-95, singing George Jones the whole way that I drive. Couldn't tell if I was glad enough to be back home with 3 new gray hairs and 2 old tires blown. So exhausted from a trip around the world, the last thing on my mind was a Boston girl. But you see, Boston girls know how to deal with the traffic. It's the original speed that I wrote the song at. Boston girls don't have attitude, cause they have it. They can be dressed up, they can be dressed down. Down. They noticed what to do when the man's in town, so I was picking the weeds in my lonely backyard. When somebody turned around to hear a lawnmower start, it was a beautiful brunette, they got out of my way. I said, whose lawn is this anyway? It can be yours and mine if we work real hard, cause the best kind of love is in your own backyard. best kind of love is in your own backyard. So if we're love done light, take a trip around the world for a job done right, go find a Boston girl. Boston girl. Boston girl. Boston girl. Boston girl. Boston girl. So I moved here to Boston with a band from college. And when we moved here, we had very, very big dreams. We were the biggest band on our college campus, which went to college outside of Buffalo, New York. It's the usual applause Buffalo gets. Not even one clap, including in Buffalo, when I play Buffalo. But we were the biggest band on our campus. We were one of only two bands on campus, but we did very, very well. So we moved to Boston with very, very, very big dreams. And we broke up within the first 6 months when I moved here, because we picked up the Boston Band Guide, and it said, Boston Band Guide, over 3,000 original rock bands in Boston. So we broke up, and I found myself kind of in Boston for no apparent reason. So I lucked out and got a very, very good job at the Copley Plaza Hotel as a purchaser. And so the first year, I was like, well, it's okay. I don't have to play music. I can just work. And I was very, very happy and content. And then by the second year, I started thinking, I'm kind of young, and I'm working with a lot of people who are older than me, and that's okay. I can learn from them. And the third year, I was like, I finally had that thought, like, is this going to be my whole life? And I kind of panicked. So by the fifth year, I was just walking through the halls, just people would say hi to me, and I wouldn't even hear them. I just zoned out. And my father called me one day at work, just randomly during the day, and he said, Chris, are you still writing songs every day? And I said, yeah, I'm still writing all the time. He said, well, why don't you quit the job and try and make a living off your songs? And I said, Dad, you been drinking by any chance? And he said, no, not yet. I will be later. So I did. I quit my job the next week. And at that time, I had a very, very healthy bank account. I just remember that about 3 months passed, and one numerical column just kind of fell off my bank account and just drifted away or just gone. And I could live with that. And then about 6 months passed, and the next numerical column just floated away. And I started to really panic. And there's a store called the Garment District in Cambridge where they used to buy your used clothes. So I started to sell my used clothes. That's where the first line of this song came from. Well, I was selling my clothes because I was running out of money. Don't think I didn't know they were gonna come to get me. And everywhere I'd go, it felt like somebody's watching. Cause I was selling my clothes, cause the only thing I know is the losing it. So I started working hard, I did a lot of heavy lifting. I juggled two jobs as I battled my addictions. In the lumber yard, another mopping up the kitchen. I juggle two jobs up against the odds of losing it. But I never lost hope. Though change came so slow, I never lost hope. I prayed real hard to the northernmost star to shine on me. That's the day my luck changed, changed, changed. The day that I started singing, I broke out of my cage and my phone started ringing. I'd get lost on the stage, feeling the lost in the music. I'd get lost on the stage from the bus to the plane I was flying. But I never lost hope. Though change came so slow, I never lost hope. Prayed real hard to the northernmost star to shine on me. Today I bought a big house, 'cause I made a little money. Every time I go out, someone wants something from me. But I never forget the lonely place where I started, when I was selling my clothes, watching every door close on the losing end. I was selling my clothes, watching every door close on the losing end. On the losing end. On the losing end. On the losing end. Well, thank you so much.
I appreciate it. You want to play two more songs, then pretend that's the end of the show? And then if you clap, I'll play another song. So it's got to be in professional show business. Since I started writing songs, I've gotten a lot of nice offers for various films. But it's usually not that glamorous. A lot of times I'll get phone calls, and it's like, Chris, we want to use your song for a film. And so I start thinking Hollywood, and they say, it's a documentary about lead pipe fitting, and I'd like to think your song would fit in perfectly. It's a documentary, it's a feel-good documentary about the after effects of asbestos in the late 70s, Chris, and we'd like to use your entire catalog. I'm like, you can use it all for free, because I don't know who's going to watch that movie. And then occasionally you get the other side of things where we got a call a couple years ago. We said, Chris, you want to use your song for a film? And so I'm automatically picturing lead pipe. I know I'm cynical, but I picture lead pipe fitting immediately. And so they start describing the film, and they say, well, it's a romantic comedy. And it stars Pierce Brosnan, Selma Hayek, and Jessica Alba. And we're going to use two of your songs in three different spots. In fact, we reshot one of the montage scenes to fit your song specifically. And in the next scene, Selma Hayek gets slowly and seductively undressed while your song plays in the background. And I'm sitting there listening to this phone call, and I'm like, what? And suddenly, I start picturing, like, this is it. I don't have to tour anymore. I was going to stay home, wait for the checks to roll. This is my moment. It has arrived. I'm done. No more playing Omaha, Nebraska. No more playing Cleveland like I do twice a year every year. I'm just going to stay home. And the movie was in theaters for about a week and a half. And went straight to Netflix. So what I'm trying to say is I'm very glad to be here at Hale Reservation this evening. In Westwood, Massachusetts. The movie is called Some Kind of Beautiful, if you want to watch it.
set off. Secretly scared we get lost. Up in the clouds, over the town, beyond the wall. Some of us knew we might fall under the weight of it all. And though we've been warned of the oncoming storms, still we stood tall. Soar from the moonlight straight to the sunrise. This will be our time to free fall and nose dive. Out of the black night into the bright lights, with the whole world in our sight, like a miniature paradise. On the ground, while I'm flying too fast to look down at the rooftops and trees and my family waving at me. Soar from the moonlight straight to the sunrise. This will be our free fall and nose dive. Out of the black night into the bright lights, with the whole world in our sight, like a miniature paradise.
This is my pretend last song. Thank you for being here this evening. I hope it's been as magical for you as it's been for me. Every single note from my perspective has been like sheer ecstasy, and I hope you feel the same way. I'll save the thank yous in case I come back for an encore, just in case. This next song is the biggest song that I've ever been involved with. This was a song that I had in a film called August Rush, which the film your soundtrack was very, very big. It sold 498,000 copies. It's 2,000 copies away from being gold. And I had the best-selling song off the soundtrack, not to brag, but the soundtrack was up for a Grammy, so my wife and I got to go to the Grammys in 2009. You know, now I'm still milking an old story. I realize that. It's 2009. Still okay. You have the 10-year window to still milk it. But I didn't sing the song in the film. The actor Jonathan Rhys-Meyers sings it. He's a very, very handsome Irish actor. So there's literally thousands upon thousands of cover versions of the song on YouTube, except that they always credit it as written by Jonathan Rhys-Meyers, which I have no problem with. I have no ego about the song. I'm very open. I'm just happy the song is out there. That's why I talk about it every single night on stage. And I reclaim it, and I take credit for it. And I don't often refer to myself in the third person, but I like to play a song by Chris Trapper right now. And as written by and interpreted by Chris Trapper. So thank you for listening to me. I really, really appreciate it. I'm not going to go anywhere after this song because I think we may have a little chat, Eric and I. So, but thank you for listening. I really, really appreciate it.
Tonight the sky above reminds me of your love, walking through winter time when the stars all shine. The angel on the stairs will tell you I was there under the front porch light on a mystery night. I've been sitting watching life pass from the sidelines. I've been waiting for a dream to seep in through my blinds. I wonder what might happen if I left this all behind. Would the wind be at my back? Could I get you off my mind this time? The neon lights and bars and headlights from the cars started a symphony surrounding me. Of things I left behind that melted in my mind, but now there's a purity inside of me. I've been sitting watching life pass from the sideline. I've been waiting for a dream to seep in through my blinds. I wonder what might happen if I left this all behind. Would the wind be at my back? Could I get you off my mind this time? I've been sitting watching life pass from the sidelines. I've been waiting for a dream to seep in through my blinds. I wonder what might happen if I left this all behind. Would the wind be at my back? Could I get you off my mind? This time.
Thank you so much, Hale Reservation. Thank you.
Hello. We're standing
hey,
so close.
Hey, what's up, man? So I said to Chris, I like to come up and chat with people. He's like, yeah, that sounds cool. What are we going to talk about? I don't know. we'll see. But, you know,
econometric models from the late 1800s.
That sounds perfect.
Yeah, let's do it.
You know, I don't know what that would mean, but
I don't either.
Okay. It's a good thing the two of us are up here to talk about that then. One of the things that I was noticing, it was something on your website, you talked about the amount of times you've gotten to play with a variety of other people that have meant something to you over the years. And so you travel around a lot, 150 days a year. Mm-hmm. You often playing with some people. And who are those people that have like sort of stood out to you that you've had that chance to be with and play music with?
Colin Hay is a guy who I tour with very often. And so he was a guy who I never met. He sang for Men at Work, if you know Land Down Under and into those songs. And when I met, you had a bunch of big kind of stadium anthems. And when I met him, we were playing the Edmonton Folk Festival together. And he said one of his songs, it helped me through a breakup in college, one of his solo songs. And when I first heard his solo song, I didn't even know it was him. Because it was such a different sound from Men at Work. It was such a very intimate, beautiful, solo, acoustic kind of breakup love song. And so I kind of thought to myself, that's the same guy, Men at Work. That's the singer from Men at Work singing this beautiful folk song. Like, it doesn't seem possible. And so since the Edmonton Folk Festival, we became friends. And I had written him saying, could we do a couple gigs at some point? Because, just long story short, I'd fired my agent. You know, I had a big gap in my tour schedule. Just some inside baseball.
So this is really inside baseball is what we're
very
got
inside
right now.
Baseball.
Yeah, right.
And so it started out
two gigs.
Do you
tell the story when the old agent's around? I hope not.
No, of course not. Okay, no, it wasn't bad terms. It was just time to go.
Time to go.
And so Colin said, you can have a couple gigs. And then a couple gigs, you became basically 6 years of touring together.
Wow.
Because we became such good friends. And so he sang on one of my albums. And so I've sung with him.
That's great.
In his movie, I do interviews about him. And he came to our house for dinner in Westwood. He was at our house. So he's one of these guys who's an iconic voice.
Right, right.
He's such a beautiful, humble person, too. And so I've studied him just as an off-the-stage persona, just because how he treats people so beautifully and so humbly. Even though he's had these massive hits and he never has to work again in his whole life, he's been a wonderful guy. And then John Prine I got to play with once. And so John Prine's a very important figure because my parents loved him. And so right after my mom
died.
That's
why he's important? It's just because your parents loved him?
Well, that's a big part of it.
That's the only reason he's at.
Well, because I grew up hearing his voice.
All the time in the house.
All the time. Yeah,
right.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. It just stood out.
Yeah. And so I never thought I'd ever play with him. And then I got a call one day, do you want to open for John Prine? And I thought it was a prank phone call, honestly. And so I opened for him, and then the last song, he asked me to sing a duet with him.
Oh, wow. That must have been.
And so that was a wild thing. And my mom, it just passed away about a month before this happened. Mm. And so I always thought that if she could have seen that happen, because she loved him more than anybody else, she would sit and drink beers late at night. And she played John Prine records to the point that the records no longer played.
The needles were worn out.
You'd be like, scratch, scratch, scratch. A little bit of John Prine's voice, scratch, scratch, scratch. But I still recognize the songs, though.
Right, right, right. And he's starstruck. I mean, that was one of those. I mean, John Prine, right? He's this amazing artist who's just, you know, an icon in this industry.
Yeah.
And were you a little starstruck when you got up there with him? Did you hold it together?
I kind of thought I could have been dreaming, possibly.
Yeah.
I was thinking, this cannot be real.
Right, yeah.
And then Rob Thomas has sung my song, give a shows. I toured with him a bunch of times, and so we become friends. And I've been very lucky to tour with very talented people.
Yeah,
so
that's great. And a lot of this, the Push Stars was sort of the impetus to get all this going, right? And
yeah,
that's right. 10 years ago, am I right about that? About 10 years ago, you guys sort of put a hold on things.
Yes, where was, and you were saying to Sophia, because she plays Austin a lot, and so I was saying that's where we started.
Yeah.
In Austin, Massachusetts. We had this one monthly Irish pub gig that we kept playing again and again.
Were the TVs on while you were playing in that monthly gig?
Like we learned very quickly that they should be shut off, so all the attention is on the band.
Right.
Shut the sports off.
You know what I've learned from Chris is you can buy one of those remote controls that'll automatically... It'll automatically shut off all TVs in
that's
a bar.
That's also inside baseball.
Inside baseball.
By the way, you shouldn't even know about that.
Right. Oh.
But if a band shuts off your favorite game, I didn't suggest this.
This might be his idea. Yeah. That might be his idea. Yeah. So what's going on with the Push Stars now? You guys are sort of re-energizing a bit.
Yeah, we
right?
just recorded a record in Memphis, Tennessee.
Yeah.
And we did like a 16-show tour in 18 days.
That's great.
And we're going to do some more stuff and... I'm going back from solo to band stuff because I love both art forms.
Yeah.
I probably love this art form more to just get up on stage and do a show with one guitar.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You can try and make it interesting
yeah.
versus the band show. But I love both art forms. And I love my bandmates too. So
yeah, that's great. Yeah, there's something different about the solo thing. It's all you right now.
Yeah,
there's
yeah.
no one to turn yeah. to except for
it's a hard to keep it interesting. You guys know it's hard to keep it interesting with
right.
one guitar.
So. That's why you bring out the ukulele yeah. every once in a while.
You gotta
mix
break it
up a little bit and you know change it up a little bit.
You have to break that out.
That's great. Well, hey, thanks for coming out and playing with
Thank
us.
Thank you,
We've
Eric.
Been really, it's been great to have you here. How about yeah. a couple more songs from Chris Trapper tonight?
All right. Thanks, Eric.
Thank you.
All right, two more songs. Hey. Did this unplug? Okay. I'm always fascinated by the art of songwriting. I've been a songwriter now professionally for about 20 years. And if you think of all the songs that have ever been written, probably 95%... songwriting, they're all love songs. You know, virtually, if you go back to the 1950s, 1940s, it's all puppy love and teenage love, and it's always songs about falling in love. That's easy. That inspiration is easy. I'm falling in love. Everything about you is perfect. Nothing about you smells. You have no morning breath. Your hair is always perfect. You don't have any winter outfits that are particularly frumpy. But it's a much more difficult topic to write a song about staying in love. So this is my attempt. You and I know how to weather the weather, even though we have holes in our shoes. But still we learned that you never say never. You were covered in tubes in a hospital bed. I said I will love you still. Say I'll wait for you to put your fake teeth in. You say you'll wait for me to spray on my hair. You'll still steal my heart when there's nobody to reach in. I'll be kissing you when you take your last gasp of air. 'Cause I will still be there. Break into or turn into a skeleton, I'll give you my skin. I'll give you my skin. You know you have the most beautiful body. Hate to remind you, but someday you won't. You'll be 85 at changing time, and I'll still sneak peeking. Can't wait to see the face you make over the hill. 'Cause I will love. tuck it in. If you're broken down, I'll give you my skin. If you break into or turn into a skeleton, I'll give you my skin.
All right, this is not my pretend last song. This is my official last song. All right, so one more big round of applause to Sophia Jane from Westwood, Massachusetts. Won't you give it up? I should say originally from Westwood, now from Boston. I went from Boston to Westwood. So I went the opposite way. So thank you very much for listening to me. I really, really appreciate it very, very much. I should say that I have CDs and action figures and bobbleheads and a full clothing line and a fragrance. And did I say bobbleheads? Yeah, I said bobbleheads. My two sons will be selling it after the show, and they are getting paid 10%. Which is in line with all child labor laws. So stop by and say hi to them after the set. And thanks to Hale Reservation and to Eric and to Tom for having me this evening. Hale Reservation has obviously meant a lot to my family, and my kids have had many summers filled with joy here, and there's a snapping turtle that we're still going to come back and visit, even if we move on from here. But give it up for Hale Reservation for doing a cool thing to have a concert here. It's a very cool thing. Thanks for doing sound, and thanks for booking me. Appreciate it. I never thought, when Tom first approached me on the beach, I was very, very insecure about my beach body here at the membership beach. So Tom approached me and said, "Would you like to play a show here?" So I was thinking, on the beach, or where would I play? Or he said, "No, in the winter." I'm like, an outdoor show in the winter. And he said, "No, there's a place inside where you can play." And so this is it. And you showed up. So thank you so much for being here. I appreciate. If you weren't here, it'd just be very, very awkward. So thank you for showing up. So I realize I can't end my show with a sad, depressing love song. So I'm going to pick things up right now with a song about death. Just to send you off into the beautiful Westwood night. When I first started out playing in Boston, I was playing only Irish pubs, almost exclusively the first couple years, because I realized early on that was the only gig that would pay. So I got to hear a lot of Irish drinking songs. And I realized one night, very late at night, that for whatever odd reason, every Irish drinking song has at least one or two verses that talk about death. And so I thought to myself, in case that market ever comes back, the Irish drinking death song,
I'm going to have my own. I'm going to beat the competition. So here's my Irish drinking death song. Put the cake on my coffin and think of me ever so often. Have a loser's day parade for all my friends. Drink up life like a river till the pizza man delivers. Smile and know I loved you till the end. Here's what to do when my time comes to pass. Charlie told me through the reflection in his glass. Don't waste time praying, 'cause I'm never coming back. Just throw a party in my name. Put the cake on my coffin and think of me every so often. Have a loser's day parade for all my friends. Drink up life like a river till pizza man delivers. Smile and know I loved you till the end. Here's what to write on the stone over my grave. His friends were earned and not a penny saved. Don't waste time crying, 'cause you two are on your way to meet me at the pawn shop in the sky. Put the cake on my coffin and think of me every so often. Have a loser's day parade for all my friends. Drink up life like a river till the pizza man delivers. Smile and know I loved you till the end.
So I realize that we have not sung anything together this whole night. Before we go, we should sing together. You don't have to sing my song. You can sing your own favorite song, whatever you enjoy singing. Let's have total cacophony as far as I care, but let's all sing together. Westwood Cable Access TV is watching us right now, so sing something. Okay, here we go. This song starts up with a keg in my coffin, then just make it up. Here we go. Put the keg on my coffin and think of me every so often. Have a loser's day parade for all my friends. Drink up life like a until the pizza man delivers. Smile and know I loved you till the end. That was very good singing. It was like a Tuesday night in Norwood. But this is a Thursday night in Westwood. And there's literally nobody can hear us. This is the most isolated gig I've ever done in my entire life. So you can sing as loud as you fucking want. So just go, like, it's karaoke night at 1:45 a.m. Like, you're thinking you're the best singer in the whole world. Let's go for it. Here we go. Put the cake on my coffin and think of me every so often. Have a loser's day parade for all my friends. Drink up life like a river till the pizza man delivers. Smile and know I loved you till the end. One more time. Put the cake on my coffin and think of me every so often. Have a loser's day parade for all my friends. Drink up life like a river till the pizza man delivers. Smile and know I loved you till the end. Smile and know I loved you till the end. Should have clapped earlier. Smile and know till the end. Smile and know I loved you till the end. Till the end. Smile and know I loved you till the end.
Thank you, Hale Reservation, so much. Thank you.
Thank you again all for coming. Chris, that was fantastic. Real quick, I got three things for you. There will be another Live at Hale event in May. Stay tuned. Sophia is playing tomorrow night at the Bebop, and Chris will be in New Jersey. And he will be at April 7th at Kingston Math at the South Shore Folk Club. And please be very careful walking out. It is icy. Thank you all very much for coming tonight. Have a good evening.